Hi everyone, Ben here from 100 Story Building. Now, if you're watching this video, it's probably because you've made a Twine story in one of our workshops. And what I'm going to show you today is how you can export that story into a file that you can share with us and anybody else. I'm also going to show you how you can make a backup of all your stories. So, I'm going to go into Twine. Now, I'm just going to assume that you're using Twine on the internet using the website twinery.org, and I'm going to show you how to do it there. But if you are using the app, it's actually pretty much exactly the same. Just open up the app and follow the other instructions. So I'm going to go to twinery.org, and if you are at twinery.org, you just need to click on the little post-it note where it says use it online. Here we go. Now you can see I've got a bunch of stories here. Let's use this one, the placeholder story, as an example. Okay, and click on that, and what we've got is a very short story, but I think I should change the name. So I'm going to go in here, click on the name of the story, and then rename story. And yeah, look, it's not very stupid. It's a perfectly good placeholder story by Ben. There we go. Okay, and I'll rename it. We'd like you to do that if you're going to share your stories with us too, so we know who the story is by. Okay, now once it's named how I want it to be named, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the menu. And then I'm going to click this, publish to file. Now that is going to save a copy of the file to my default download location. Now where it ends up will be different depending on what kind of computer you're using, but usually you'll have some sort of downloads folder, and that's probably where it's going to go. It also uses the exact name you typed in for the title as the name of the file. So if you're having trouble finding it, you do a search on your computer for the name of your story. And you can also do this in the short menu or the shortcut way, which is using that little cogwheel. Those same options are available there. Now, the other thing you can do is click on this button, archive, and what that'll do is save a big file that's got all of your stories in it. And that's named with the date and time that you saved it, and then it's called Twine Archive. So if you're having trouble finding these files, if you search for Twine Archive or the name of your story, it'll help you figure out where it is on your hard drive. Well, look, that's pretty much all from me. I hope that you do export your Twine stories and save a backup. And if you do, I can't wait to read them. And if you excuse me, I've kind of got to get back to typing the story.